You may be seated.
We are gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this covenant to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commanded of St. Paul to be honored among all men and in the fear of God. If any man can show any just cause why they may not be lawful joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. I require and charge you both, and you will answer in that dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be discovered, that if either of you know any reason why you shall not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be you well assured that if any person are joined together otherwise, and as God's word does allow, their marriage is not lawful. Chad, will you take this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in holy estate matrimony, where thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in secret, and in health as long as you both shall live? Destiny, will thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony, where thou obey him and serve him and love and honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto him, for as long as you both shall live? Who gives this woman to be married to this man? First Corinthians chapter 13 describes the kind of love which you must build your home upon. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not irritable or moody. Love does not insist on its way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoice in the right. Love bears all things, believeth all things, hope all things, endure all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. And now, Chad, the scripture says to the husband, husband, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might present it unto himself a glorious body, glorious church, and not have a spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy, without blemish, so ought men to love their wife. Now, Destiny, the scripture says to the wife, wife, submit yourself unto your husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, that the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wife be to their own husband in everything. And to you both, the scripture says, submit yourself one to another in the fear of God. And Chad, and Destiny, if you'll always put Jesus Christ first, put one another second, and put the church third, you'll have a happy marriage.
Chad, repeat after me. I, Chad, take thee, Destiny, to be my wedded wife, To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better. For worse. For richer. For poor. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. To death us do part. According to God's holy orders. Thereto I pledge thee my faith. I, Destiny, take thee, Chad, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love, to cherish, and to obey, to death us do part. According to God's holy orders, and thereto I pledge thee my troth. The bride's ring, please. As a pledge and in token of the vows between us made, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. The groom's ring, please. As a pledge and a token of the vows between us made, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
I'm gonna mess it all up. This is my buddy. Take care of him. Believe you will. Two good people. Today, Chad and Destiny have chosen to braid these three strands together into a single cord. Each strand has a significant meaning. The ivory strand represents God and His majesty. The blue strand represents the groom and his life. The white strand represents the bride and her life. In braiding these three strands together, Chad and Destiny have demonstrated that their marriage is more than a joining of two lives together. It is a unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. Ecclesiastes 9 and 12 reads, "Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat. But how can one be warm alone? If one prevail against him, two shall withstand with him. And a threefold cord is not quickly broken." Today, Chad and Destiny will be woven together by God as one in marriage. One man, one woman, and God. It was God who taught us to love by keeping Him at the center of your marriage. His love will continue to bind you together as one throughout your marriage.
Thank you.
This man and this woman, who we bless on thy name, and may ever remain in love and peace together. These whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Chad and Destiny have consented together in holy wedlock, and witnessed the same before God and the company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to one the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are man and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. You may kiss the bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Chad Letty.
Now that I got my Wait, Kevin, what's this going to say to us?
How much is that little one?
Oh, we have cooler drinks in there. It just, I don't know. There's like one of them or something to throw.
What are you doing about Chad?
I asked you where they were, you didn't respond.
Four different names for that minute. Maybe behind, I didn't know which one looked good.
I've been trying to get out of this since it came about.
You should have just stood there.
That would make it even better.
Well, she told me, she said, all you got to do is get out and kiss my hand. I'll tell you that. It's not like I'm trying to have it.
I thought I was about to pass out. What was that? Yeah. Oh, bad. I didn't even have the truck cranked up today, Steve.
You know, we got to stay here about 20 minutes to pitch it.
Oh, okay.
Come on, re-crank it.
Oh, okay. I got a full tank of
gas. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. three, two, one. All right, let's give her a hand. Assume the